My eyes go quite glassy. They just want to close. I get hallucinations, like a dark figure in the corner of the room. Something's touching me, tapping, but they got far worse than that. I couldn't even stay awake for 5 minutes. I'm Jana and I'm 34 years old and I have narcolepsy type 1 or narcolepsy with cataplexy. Narcolepsy is a neurological sleep disorder. Basically, you can't stay awake and you can't stay asleep. People think of narcolepsy like just dropping to the ground and falling asleep, but they're getting that mistaken for actually cataplexy. Cataplexy is muscle weakness triggered by strong emotions. Sometimes if I'm really laughing or if I'm really upset, I won't be able to hold my head up. I can trace back early symptoms at least 17 years before I was diagnosed. Just an overwhelming feeling of tiredness. You put it down to other things, and being young as well, you thought, okay, maybe I was out too late with my friends. I went to several different GPs. They would send me for a blood test, thinking, okay, it might be iron, B12, something easy, but everything always came back normal. One of the first hallucinations that I saw was just a dark figure in the corner of the room. Someone standing there in like a cloak, like a shadow. People with narcolepsy experience hallucinations because we're constantly awakening and you're still having sometimes the dream around you. They can be tactile. It feels like someone's trying to pull you out of bed or scratching you. Holding me down and holding my mouth as well so I couldn't yell. Told my mum about it and she was like, okay. I think she thought I was going a little bit crazy. I probably thought I was going a little bit crazy too. As the years went on, some days I was in a constant loop, falling asleep at the desk, falling asleep at the wheel, trying to push through these sleep attacks. If you try and push through it, part of your brain can switch off. That's called automatic behaviour. You can continue what you're doing, but at a much lesser quality. I look totally different. I walk totally different. I was doing it driving. It's really scary. Like, I didn't know at the time that that's what was happening. When you come out of it, you're like, oh my gosh, how long have I been doing this? And how haven't I crashed? Because a lot of people end up crashing their cars and things. Doctors often would try and give me antidepressants. I'm like, you're not listening to me though. I'm not depressed, I'm tired, I'm exhausted. Every day was a struggle and couldn't really see the light. After struggling for so many years, I went to a new GP and said, look, here's all my symptoms. I'm not leaving until you give me a referral for a sleep study. Booked in with the sleep specialist. He was 99.9% certain that I had narcolepsy. It was good to have an answer, finally. He said to me, you've done a good job living until now. So I was like, wow, yes, I kind of have. When I look back, cataplexy was probably one of the first things that showed up and I wasn't aware. It's under the same umbrella as cataplexy and it's called orgasmolepsy. Very brief, like, but full body muscle weakness on climax. I laugh about it now because I must have been thinking, look at me go, making her go all week, but it was me, not you. It was the sleep disorder. Definitely in the last 3 years, I've learnt that it's so much easier once you're diagnosed. My daughter always keeps me going and always has. There is no cure for narcolepsy, but I've learnt for me, trying to fast most of the day seems to help the medication work better to get me through the sleep attacks. I've also gained access to NDIS, so that was a game changer. Getting things done around the house and having the help. I still have cataplexy. You learn maybe what some of the triggers are. Sort of try and take a deep breath and just pivot. Mindfulness. You get more connected with self, learning different sensations of a sleep attack. You start to be more in tune with your body. I'm throwing myself into advocacy and awareness. That's not talked about enough. Many people wait a long time for diagnosis. It's given me purpose. Feels like I'm doing something important, not only for me, but for many others. To learn more about narcolepsy, look for the links in the comments.